my English class. Today we will discuss about future time. Okay, look at this. Future time. In future time, we have already discussed about one part. Now we will use present continuous tense. Present continuous tense is used in for future time. Because if we add future time with present continuous, we can express for future time to talk about plans made for a particular time in the future. Look at this. To talk about a plans, about a plan made for a particular time in the future. If we talk about future time and it is already fixed, we have decided to do that work, we have a plan to do this work, then we can use this structure PJMR plus verb plus other words plus future time. Okay, children? So here, look at this. We will take some example. I am buying a new book. Talk about plans made for a particular time in the future. Here we will use present continuous with future time. Look at this. Soon, S-O-O-N, soon, is expressing future time. So, I am buying, B-U-Y-I-N-G, I am buying a new bicycle soon. Then, we are having a picnic tomorrow. Tomorrow is future time, but here we are having a picnic. It is present continuous. We add future time with it, so it became future time. You are selling your bicycle. You are selling your bicycle. Means very soon. You decided to sell it. He is returning next week. That means he will come next week. That means it is expressing future time. They are going to play. Now they are not playing, but they will play after some time. So we can express in future, in present continuous, not future time. They are going to play. Suppose it is a physical period. You are coming down the steps to go to the playground to play for some time. Suppose your friend see you at the time of coming. So he will ask you, where are you going? Then you will say, we are going to play, or I am going to play. So in this way, we express the future time. Okay? Here we use present continuous with future time to express future work. What will we do after some time? We can express through future, present continuous or future time. Okay? Then we will discuss about present simple. Through present simple, we can also express future time. Subject plus verb plus other words. It is simple present with future time. To talk about future events which are on a timetable or a fixed plan. Suppose we have already fixed it. Suppose today is, what day is today? Today is Monday and next day is Tuesday. It is fixed, it cannot be changed. So when we talk about it, we can express through simple present tense. Look at this. When we talk about the train time, the mail express comes at 7 a.m. every day. It comes. So we express it is fixed, that the train timetable is fixed. Suppose your half yearly examination will be held on 20th October. Then we can say our examination starts on 20th October or November. We can select this in this way. here we use present simple tense plus future time. Look at this. To talk about future events which are on a timetable or a fixed plan. If it is fixed, because commencement of examination is not suddenly fixed, it is fixed before. So in this case, we use simple present plus future time. Look at this, we will take some examples. Tomorrow is a holiday. Suppose it will be a holiday. So we can express tomorrow is a holiday or tomorrow is Tuesday. The Konark Express arrives at 4 p.m. at Brahmapur Station. The next meeting is on Sunday. Then our examination starts tomorrow. That means before you have got the timetable. So these events are expressed with the help of simple present. So there is no future tense in English grammar, because we can express future words or future one or time in the, with the help of present continuous, present simple, then be plus be gone, be plus going to. We are going to do this work. And the first part, this is the second part and this is the third part. And after that we will discuss about the next, the future time with will shall plus verb. Okay children, you have to write these things in your best notebook or English practice notebook one by one and by heart these things, because it is very necessary for direct indirect and active and passive voice. So children, my heart is here. Have a nice day. Thank you very much.